This is something I know the Reddit community is very sick of. Every time you turn around, there's another desk setup photo being posted, and the base of it is Nikea Alex drawer. But I mean, when you really think about it, it's for good reason though. All right, so let's talk about it. What are the other options? Okay, you have the poles that you can use as legs. You have these standing desk legs that you can use. And then you can go buy these pre-built desktops, but most often they're ugly, they're clunky, and they don't even fit right in your space. They're just overall ugly. The reason I think the IKEA Alex drawers are super popular is first and foremost the aesthetic. You cannot deny they are aesthetically pleasing to look at. They're well-made. They come in a variety of colors. So there's white, there's black. I know there was a good, like a darker blue at one point. It's not available now. They have a turquoise gray. Can't speak. Turquoise gray. There's like a wood stain color that they have right now. And then there used to be a solid gray if my memory is right. Some of those colors are older, but you get my point. And lastly, each IKEA Alex drawer is less than $100. So you're not paying like $200 for each one. When you go out and look at websites like Target and Wayfair, the price is just way up there on those sites as compared to the IKEA Alex drawers. You get one for just like $89. I think it used to be $79 technically, but $89 still isn't bad. With all of that said, it's easy to see why people constantly, over and over, continue to buy the IKEA Alex drawers and include them in their desk setup photos. But I need to go on a mini rant for a second. You know what's annoying? That these big companies like Target and Walmart can't replicate the success of the IKEA drawer and just fill in the gaps that are left behind from IKEA not being able to produce and logistically just like ship out all of these cabinets. If you work in the marketing department of one of those companies, will wake up. I know it's more complicated because then you have the production concerns and all that, but there needs to be a marketing push by companies like I just said, Target and Walmart, to really put dollars into the home setup desk space. Now, I know there are many sellers on Walmart's third party marketplace area. I'm not really comfortable with that, but they make drawers that look 100% like the IKEA Alex drawers. But when you look closer, some of the reviews are kind of hit or miss, right? Some pieces are missing, you know, the boards arrive damaged. The customer service is bad. It's just like, do I want to trust that? I don't know. One thing that's been frustrating myself and you as well is, why is IKEA always out of stock on everything? I've been trying to get the IKEA Alex drawers ever since December of last year. So it's well over a year. Actually, it was before then. So probably since last summer. So in a year and a half, I've been trying to get these Alex drawers, but it's been difficult. However, I recently just picked up 4 Alex drawers. So I'm really happy about that. I have 2 built so far. You saw that in my how to build the IKEA Alex drawer video, but we'll talk about that later. So because I'm sure IKEA got sick of y'all asking about, when is this going to be in stock? When is that going to be in stock? Hey, you know what? They went ahead on their website and put up a section specifically talking about stock availability. So let's put everything in perspective, right? IKEA's products are designed in Europe and they're manufactured in 10 different countries, if I'm not mistaken. Plus, the production facility that handles all the wood-based products is located in southern Poland. Hold on, let me read this because I don't want to mess it up. Their top 5 production countries are Poland, Russia, Slovakia, Portugal, and Sweden. Top 5. And the United States isn't even in there. So when you think about the, you know what, virus affecting everything, just think about all those container vessels, the container ships, you know, that were stuck out at different docking stations. Then, you know, the ones that we saw in California that were just sitting out there in the sea, not able to dock. Then there weren't enough workers to, you know, unload everything. And then there wasn't enough truckers to just like transport stuff across America. Keep that in mind while we're sitting right here frustrated, because I know myself, I had to put a lot of things in perspective. Just keep that in mind. As some of you know, IKEA has 3 inventory like color symbols. The red means that it's out of stock. The yellow means that there's low inventory, and the green means that they have in stock. Now, don't fully trust that green light when you see it, because when I was in store, I did a search on the computer for, you know, one of the kitchen countertops to use as my desktop, and I saw just as low as like the number 12. A 12 inventory shows up as green. So make sure you don't look at that green light and think, oh, there's hundreds of, you know, this product available, because that's not the case. When we're sitting at our computers at home, we can't see the number on our end, right? You have to call the person at IKEA or actually physically be there in the store to check that. With that being said, if you see something green, run. Don't walk to your credit card. That's essentially what I did when I saw these drawers in stock. I got my card, I placed my click and collect order, and then because, you know, there was limited availability of when I could go pick it up, I had to go pick it up on Christmas Eve. So I drove the 2.5 hours, yes, 2.5 hours to the only IKEA in my state and picked up the IKEA Alex drawers. When you place your click and collect order, know that you most likely have 24 hours to pick it up. You know, some stores have different practices, but I think my store follows the 24-hour rule because that's what I saw. I read online that other stores might do 2 to 3 days. I'm sure you can call if you have like an extenuating circumstance where you can't like go and pick it up, and they'll be, you know, kind enough to extend out a day or two for you. But in general, if you place a click and collect order, pick it up within 24 hours, because if not, they're gonna refund you. Just think about how many people are constantly coming to IKEA stores to get different products and placing their orders online. So they don't wanna hold up a specific piece just for you for a couple of days. So now let's talk about the dimensions, the weight of the package, you know, all that good stuff. How many will fit in your car? Will it fit in your car? Let's get into that. So when I got to IKEA, I did the electronic wait in line thing at 9 a.m. and then they promptly brought out my order to me. I was able to pack the four of mine in the trunk of my car. Now, if I had bought two more, I'm sure I could have put those in the back seat, but more than six would not have been doable whatsoever, because I could not fit a package inside the passenger seat of my car. It was just too big. Speaking of dimensions, each box is about 23 inches by 32 inches, and boy, are they heavy. I had to go look on IKEA's website, and it lists each box at 61 pounds and 11 ounces. And I was like, man, my heart was going fast, just lifting these up, you know, trying to push it up with my knee, carry it to the door, open it up, slide in, you know, do all that. My heart was racing. It was a workout. But let's talk about assembly. My previous video was all about how to assemble the IKEA Alex drawers. So if you want to know what you're getting yourself into and want step-by-step instructions on how to build the Alex drawers, watch that video. Honestly, if you're not interested, don't click on that video at all, please. But if you are interested and you want to support me for free, let me emphasize that word again, for free. Free. Watch that video in its entirety. Shoot, even watch it on 2x speed, two times as fast. Now, let's talk about attaching the IKEA Alex drawers to the tabletop that I bought that day. When building the Alex drawers, you have the option to flip-flop the top and the bottom board if you want to screw in some wooden screws into the pre-drilled holes. I chose not to do that. I just used 3M tape in each of the four corners of the Alex drawer, then placed my table directly on top. Then later on, I was able to move the whole desk setup around the room without the drawer shifting under the tabletop. Earlier, when I had just put the tabletop on the drawers and nothing in between, it shifted around way too easily. So just know you have to have something in between just to keep it steady and sturdy. My overall goal is to get rid of a dark and dreary second desk setup that I have and replace it with another one that's more minimal and lighter and brighter. Speaking of things in progress, I'm almost done with this wallpaper that I'm going to use in this new office space. So W Gang and all visitors, if you're still watching at this point, well, let's face it, because most of y'all only watch the videos for 2 minutes or 3 minutes and then y'all bounce to go do something else. But if you're still watching, that means you made it here thus far, or you skipped ahead. Either way, let me know in the comments below. W Gang, we out.
Thank you.